today, she's showing us how to get the look of a lush garden wall, but no watering required.
Yes, you do not need to have a green thumb for this.
Allie, you do not.
I do not have one. You do not have one. And I think there's a number of people who don't have one, but that's why we buy houseplants, fake houseplants at that. And so something that you're seeing a lot in home decor right now are these accent walls. So I just married the two ideas of the accent wall and then the houseplant and created this three-dimensional, truly it's a piece of art.
It's stunning.
Right here. And it's truthfully, when you break it down, you can do this.
Because it does look, this looks like a lot, but we are breaking it down.
You're
showing us over here.
Yes,
more
we'll go over here.
Simple version.
Exactly,
how to go through
so this
it all.
Is the thing. You do, this would be tough for a one person to do. This is not a one person job. You wanna get your friends. I had my friend Ro help me do this, and this is where you really need a couple different hands to build.
All right.
Not necessarily build, but to put
to put together. Okay, so how do we begin?
Okay, so this is where, this is called, this is heavy duty turf.
Okay.
So this is the background of your actual sort of art piece, art wall, if you will. So when you get this, you can get this at the hardware store. They come in a couple different kinds. So the one I have, Allie, is like super thick,
yeah.
It's heavy duty. Mm-hmm. The reason I chose this is it's very lush and full and you're not gonna be able to see like the background. Okay. So if you get the thinner one, I can, as we go, I'm gonna tell you some tricks with that as well. So that is what you're looking for in terms of the turf.
Okay.
And in terms of adding it to your actual wall, you can see I have a couple 1x3s. So you get these and you wanna be able to put it on the top. So let's pretend this is our wall. This whole thing is our wall.
Yeah.
You put one at the top and you put one at the bottom, and the trick to attaching it to the wall is to find your studs and to screw it in. And so that's what's gonna be the sturdiest thing. And because this is the heavy duty, the turf is screwed into those pieces of wood as well.
Oh, so that's nice. So it's sort of something like you're not putting screws all throughout
the wall.
It's just in these boards.
And so if you got the thinner one, so it's similar to like if you were to like play putt-putt golf and you see like the grass that is for that, the turf for that, that's what the thinner one is gonna be like. And you could potentially use a staple gun to put that in, and that would be a little bit lighter, but it's not gonna give you the full
effect.
That,
I've staple gun things to my walls before, and it actually comes up pretty easily too if you need to take it down. So what is the proper term for this? I call it chicken wire.
Yes, I call it chicken wire. So when you're going, you're looking for the supplies for this, this is a chicken wire. So Allie, you can see the whole top of our wall would be covered with that, and using the staple gun for this is possible as well.
Okay.
So you can use the staple gun for that because I'm putting it into the top pieces of the wood. And what you would do, because it comes in those big rolls, you would do it along the top and you would do it along the bottom of your wall as well.
So you put the roll, like roll it down,
staple gun.
Here?
Yep,
okay.
Exactly.
I'm
you can
following.
See, just in case you want to see, this is what the staple gun looks like right here. And you would just go in and do this. So as you can see, Allie, behind you, you see that we've created sort of like a river type of look where that's an artistic choice where you go down the center and everything around the outsides is very lush and full with the greenery. So that is where the chicken wire comes into play. You take your wire cutters and you create that sort of flow of your greenery. And here's the trick, because you want it to be taut when you stick everything in. Enter zip ties. It's a very technical thing, these zip ties. When you get them, they come in like a pack of a million, so you will definitely have enough. So all you do is you kind of pull it, and
how do you get them into here?
Oh, so I used just a utility knife.
Okay.
And cut it. If you're using the thicker one, you could definitely maybe use some scissors or something too.
Okay.
And after that, you just use your zip ties and tighten it all.
Nice.
And you can cut, and you would have...
I got this one?
Yep, exactly. So, and Allie, after that is when you can just...
And you can make any design. So like you did diagonal, but if you kind of wanted the gardening just coming down the sides, you would just have it straight down,
absolutely.
Right? Anything you want.
Yeah, you could do anything you want. And this is where you get creative with your greenery as well. Try to find these. If you want to go about doing this project, you can do that one if you want. I would recommend planning ahead of time because these things go on sale. Do not buy them full price if you're at the craft supply store. They go on sale throughout the year. And you just stick them in. Yeah, you could do in through there and then you would go and fill. So I have some Spanish moss, things like that, because that adds really great texture and color and things like that. So you would just go in and kind of fill that here or there.
Yeah.
And this would be something that you could definitely do. It takes a lot of greenery to do this. But
flowers up
here. Yeah, you could put succulents in there. You could do anything. And that's where you have that creative freedom. If you did want to add a bunch of florals, you could definitely do that as well.
I see on here you added some florals on these frames, but there's a few different ways you can decorate the frames.
Okay, so the frames, so this is where, in my mind, I kind of wanted the whole wall, our accent wall to sort of be the artwork. But yeah. Truthfully, Allie, you see the frames. You could get plain frames and paint them any color you like. We have the gold ones here, but you could dry brush them, or you could do even pastels would be kind of fun and pretty in there and tropical. But you could actually put artwork in there. I thought artwork would be pretty in there. I thought mirrors could be really pretty in there as well. Or you could really do your own sort of like greenery artwork. So you see we have the space there. You could add some like succulents or things like that, doing the same process as the chicken wire, just in the frame. But you see I have a frame here. And truthfully, in order to add any kind of detail, it's a glue gun. That's it. You have your glue gun, and all you need to do is take your faux flowers, and like I said, it's really up to you artistically how you want them to be, and you could put them along the side here, and you could even just do a bunch here, and this also gives you the opportunity, if you wanted it to be really bright, you could add in some like pink or anything like that, and they're just hot glued on there. That's all it is.
How do you get the frames on the wall?
It's like how you would put the frame up on any wall. So these ones are just on with a screw. So we screwed into the wall like we would any kind of artwork. And it went through the turf just the same as like the turf going into the wall. Yeah, so use a screw for that.
You know where I see this? Like if you have like a pool outside your house, like creating a beautiful wall like this would make it feel so tropical. Like on the side of your garage or something. I don't know.
That would be perfect. Really
cool. Or inside.
Or inside. You could do it, truthfully, you could do it anywhere. Because it just brings so much life to your house. It's like a house plant, but so much better.
Yeah. Exactly. Thank you so much, Maria. And for full instructions, head to HallmarkChannel.com. And to stay up to date with all things Maria, check her out on her website.